do this all over again, and that'd be a big... Well, I have to say, Alice, I'm glad you didn't turn pro. You stayed an amateur. I understand her. She still has a 14 handicap, so I don't have to play against her. Well, it's hard to know where to begin. You know, it's interesting to see some of these videos. There, you can tell the stage of your career by the color of your hair. And, you know, my career was just the best. Of course, I was pretty successful at it. I admit to that, and that made it more fun. So, but yeah, as he said, I started when I was 15, and turned pro when I was 19, and then in 59 and 60 we played here in French Lick. And I was on tour then, so I was able to experience, but I have to say, not this one. This is an incredible facility and resort, and you don't know, but golf, as Jan has expressed, it is has been my life since I was 15 years old. So, and it was just the best, and it is still very much a part of my life, and has brought me here this evening. And I have been inducted in the other Hall of Fames, but they're all special. And this is just as special as any of the ones that came before, maybe even more so because it's come at a time of my life. However, I didn't know that I was going to be the old one to be inducted. I didn't know that part. It's going to be fun to figure out who's going to be the next one. There's only one other here that's the same age as me, but I won't tell. But, you know, the wins were great. They were, you know, that's what you were out there to do. And sometimes I didn't always win. Somebody else lost. Sandra Haney tells a story on me. I didn't realize this at the time, but she said, I three-putted the last hole to let Whitworth win her first tournament. I said, well, I thank you very much. So if anybody else out there did that, I thank you very much. And but I also tell this story too of, you know, I sometimes you're not aware of things that are going on out there because I was too busy having a good time and playing, and that's what I was there for, and I can't tell you how much I enjoyed my career and still, but when I think back on it, I really enjoyed the travel. It didn't bother me to travel, and I was always looking forward to the next tournament. I didn't mind living out of a suitcase, and it was just there were very few of us at the very beginning, so it was a pretty small crowd, and we got to know each other and played a lot of golf. And of course, I got to play with the great players like Mickey and Betsy Rawls and Louis Suggs, and learned an awful lot from them. But you know, like, and back in those days, the press room was the parking lot, and the locker room was the back of your car. So, but it was fun. I just had the best time, and I remember thinking that I probably wouldn't. I learned some great lessons from Betsy Rawls. When I didn't really think I was going to make it. I was not playing very well, and so I went home, talked to the folks, and I said, well, you know, I just don't know, maybe I'm not cut out for this. And they said, well, you got 3 years to try. I said, oh, well, okay. So I thought, well, 3 years, I'll give myself that much time. And went back out on the tour and read an article from Betsy Rawls, and she said, well, I work harder for an 80 than I do for a 70. And I had to think about that for a little bit, and I thought, well, that's probably right. Because when you're shooting an 80, everything is going to hell in the handbasket. And you have to try a little harder. And I thought, well, I wasn't trying very hard. When I'd have a bad shot or a bad round, I was giving up, and I didn't recognize that's what I was doing. But and I'm telling the story because that week I didn't give up, and I kept playing, and that was a great turnaround for me, and I think that's why I was able to continue to win later on, because it just got to be a habit of not giving up. And I won my first check that week.
Whoop.
$33. You know, Jack's career and mine paralleled each other a little bit, and his first check was like 37. So, anyway, but those were little things that would propel me on, and we talk about equipment. I tell this story about when I first started. Some of you, and I know there are some of you old enough to know this, but there used to be the stores would give you some green stamps. When you bought some food, you'd get a bunch of these stamps, and you'd put them in these books. And my mother saved those things, and she was very stingy with them, because and they would send you a catalog to look at. And anyway, there were two golf clubs in there, a driver and a three-wood, that I was coveting. And finally talked her into it, and she let me get those two clubs. So my first brand new clubs were S&H green stamps. But the fun part about that is, in 1977 or 76 or somewhere along in there, I think, we had a tournament in Houston, and my mother was there for the week, and she'd come out, and as it was, the sponsor was S&H Green Stamps. Guess who won? So, not only did I win the tournament, and I was happy about that, but I got the money and the trophy, but I got all these green stamps. So Mom was there, and I said, okay, Mom, it's payback. So I gave her all the green stamps back. And these are the stories that I really remember and that I enjoy so much thinking back on my career. And then when I did quit, and I was one of Jack's honorary, one of his honorees, back in the mid 2004, who cares? You just didn't know, you just thought you knew how old I was. But anyway, Donnie Pepper was there, and she was asked to help present me at Jack's ceremony, which is really a wonderful ceremony. Jack really does a nice job, and I'd been there before, and knew what went on there, and so I was very, very pleased and honored to be there. But anyway, Dottie was presenting me and was doing a really nice job and been saying some really nice things and everything. And then all of a sudden, she started talking about my hair. And I thought, what are you talking about? Anyway, she said, yeah, says, when Witt's hair moved, it was a two-club win. Well, I thought about that for a while, and I thought, boy, I wished I'd have known that. I could have won a few more tournaments, I think. I could have used less or more, and they would have been in real deep trouble. But anyway, in this Hall of Fame, I think this is a wonderful thing that they've started here, and I'm very, very proud and honored to be here this evening and to be one of the first ones to go in, and certainly here with Jan Stevenson. I always thought Jan didn't really receive the recognition that she deserved. So I want to congratulate her. I do remember many times watching her and her mother and father out on the putting green till everybody else gone home or back to the hotel, and there they were out there practicing. So I know how hard she worked and how hard she does work, and so she's been, and I have to say though, I don't think I would have ever gotten a bathtub. Being the sex queen was not my line of work. But she did bring a lot of attention to us and to the LPGA, but I always thought she was a really fine player, and I'm so happy that she's been inducted here this evening and being recognized. But I wish all the players here this evening all the best. It's been fun being a part of their lives and getting to see them again, and it's always great fun to see them. And I've had chances to be with them in different environments, and it's been fun to get to know them on a different perspective, as being like the captain of the Honda and the Solheim Cup. Get to see the players in a different light, and so it's been great fun. And as I said, it's been a great ride. I've just had the best time, and I'm still having a great time, and I'm so happy to be here this evening. And thank you, the French Lick Resort, for making this happen, and enjoy the rest of the week. I'm just glad I'm not playing.